Hey Bulleteers, in this video we will learn on how to replace or inspect a bullet rear drum brake. So first step for replacing a rear drum brake is to put the bullet on a hard raised platform. The simple way to do would be to get two bricks and place them beside the center stand, then tilt the bullet and slide the brick on one side, then holding the bullet go on the other side and tilt the bullet again so that it raises on one brick and slide the other brick beneath the other side. Once it is securely raised, you can then move on to the next part. So, second step would be to mark the current position of the chain. It can be marked on this part which has got teeth. Count the number of teeth and see it will be aligned to a raised cylindrical structure, and mark the current position on one side. You can use a pencil, marker, or if you do not have anything, you can even mark it with wet soil. Once it is marked on one side, you can move on to the other side and then count the teeth and mark its current position. You can choose to either count the teeth and remember them, or if you feel you cannot remember them, you can mark it with a marker. So you can see I have marked it with a pencil. Now the third step would be to take a 24 number spanner and rotate this nut anti-clockwise. It can be very hard to rotate. You can even use hammer on the other end of this spanner to rotate it, or if you are still finding you are not able to rotate it, you can use WD-40 to loosen up the nut. Once it comes loose, you can rotate it with your fingers and remove it. Then this rod on which the nut was fixed, you can either hammer it inside. Since I don't have hammer right now, I'm just using a screwdriver and the spanner to push it inside. As you tap it inside, it comes out of the other side. So it's best to tap it well inside so you don't have to apply too much force to take it out on the other side. So now it has gone in completely and it would have come out of the other side. So now you see this rod has come out on the other side. Now you can easily pull it out holding the wheel side with your other hand. So once this rod comes out, the wheel will be free. you can remove this cylinder. The cylinder also has this ring that you remove, and then place it on the rod itself so you do not forget it later. After this, you just have to pull the wheel out by sliding it outside and then take it out of the frame. Now notice these raised bars on the brake hub. These raised bars have to, while fitting the wheel back on, these raised bars will get pushed inside the holes that you see in the wheel. These are the holes I'm talking about. So when you are putting the wheel back, you have to align these two and push the wheel inside. Now, taking a 30 size spanner, move this nut anti-clockwise. So all these nuts will be very, very hard to loosen up because they are fixed very tightly to the frame. So you'll have to apply quite a bit of pressure. Be very careful while applying pressure because they are very sharp objects in bullet frame with which you can hurt yourself. Now this is the third nut that comes out. I feel it is very tight, so I'm going to use a little bit extra torque. So I fix another spanner on this spanner. Fix it properly in place and then it loosens up easily. You can use the same method on the nuts that you feel are very hard. And once they have loosened up, you can use your spanner to loosen up the nut. So this is a size 19 spanner that I have used to loosen up this nut. And remove this chain marker. The next step is to remove this braking rod, for which you have to just keep turning this nut with a size 13 spanner. After this, you can push out the brake hub. As you can see, it has come out. Then separate it from the chain. So then you have to remove this bolt which is fixed with the chain. As you can see, the top and bottom of this bolt is flat, which slides into the bullet frame. You have to remember this. And then you separate the top part of the brake hub from the bottom part. This is a wheel bearing. There is another wheel bearing on the other side. Place the wheel bearing back and take out the bottom part which holds the both the brake shoes. You just have to raise it like this and the brakes will separate. So now the brake shoes that I see, they are in quite a good condition, so I need not replace it. Usually the now you see these are the channels into which these raised portion of the brake shoe are aligned. So while putting it back, you have to remember to place properly. Now remove the spring from the rod and you see the quality of my brake shoe is quite good. You can see a lot of leather on top and it has not reached to the metal yet. When this leather has almost reached the metal, then you have to replace the brake shoe. So while replacing, you will get the same brake shoe and a couple of springs which join both the brake shoes together. For now, I'll just roughen up the brake shoe with a coarse sandpaper. So you can do this maintenance whenever you feel that your brakes are getting very squishy and you find out that there is enough and more leather material on your brake shoe. So give both the brake shoes leather material a good scrub. Then also scrub the inside portion of your drum brake with the sandpaper. Put the spring hook back on one brake shoe and attach the spring hook back on the other. Join both the brake shoes together with the spring hook. Again, remember that while placing it back onto the frame, the channels that are there, they must align properly with the raised bumps on your brake shoe. Otherwise, if you align it or if you position it to the bottom of the frame, the brake will not work properly. So it should be the brakes should be kind of aligned to the top of the frame like this, and you can see when the channels are properly aligned with the bumps on the brake shoe. So now this is properly raised and fitted back. I'll show again how to align the channels with the brake shoe. So suppose this is a new brake shoe, you put the spring back on, then turn it inward noting the channels in the cylinder and the channels in the brake shoe. Turn it inwards as if you are breaking a bread or a biscuit. Then fix one side properly with the channel and then push it in. Raise the brake shoe on the other side till it is aligned to the top. Then put the spring hook back on the lever. Like this. It's time to wrap up and you bring both top and bottom sides together. Place this bolt inside. Then place the washer on the bolt and then put the first bolt in, and for putting in this center bolt you'll have to rotate it a bit so that the flat top and bottom are slide into the bullet frame. Then take this chain position marker and put it inside. You might have to pull back the brake hub a bit so that it you can fix it to its original position. I had marked it black with a marker later on. Then fix the nut on the center bolt. Then fix the nut
and washer
on the side bolt. You don't have to tighten it up, just make them a bit snug, because you tighten up only after you have confirmed that everything is in the right place. Now you attach the brake rod . So slide it in this cylinder hole. Push the lever back as far as it would go. And then tighten up the brake nut. You can tighten up the brakes later on, as seen in this video. Now roll the wheel back in. Now, as shown earlier in the video, the channels in the wheel have to align with the bars on the brake hub. So you have to come on the other side so that you can look at the bars and align the wheel by rotating it and then push the wheel in. Now push this ring inside and then put the cylinder on top. You might have to push the wheel a bit to make space for the cylinder. So push in the wheel so that there is space for the cylinder. Then push this rod into the cylinder through the ring and through the wheel. Then after this, you will need to set the position of this chain marker here also, count the teeth and fix it on the same position as on the other side. It has to be exactly in the same position and exactly the same number of teeth, otherwise your wheels will wobble. Then secure the marker and tap with the hammer so that the rod goes in completely. Now secure this rod with a nut. Check once whether both the chain marker are on the same position and then start tightening the nuts. So first tighten the base nut here. Then tighten the nut on top. You really will have to tighten it very hard. And then tighten up this nut on the slider. So apply full force and then rotate the wheel to see if there is any wobble. If there is not and it's rotating freely, then your rear brake replacement and inspection is done.